This video summarizes the article Asthma Remission in Adults, Role of Age at Asthma Onset, Smoking, Obesity, and Allergic Rhinitis, published in Allergy, the Journal of the European Academy of Allergy and Clinical Immunology. All credit to the original authors. Please follow the journal's license terms. Adapting figures may require permission. This narration was created with the aid of artificial intelligence. Meet Anna. She was diagnosed with asthma at 8, and today she's breathing freely again. For many adults, asthma remission is possible thanks to better maintenance therapies, targeted biologics, and supportive lifestyle changes. That's why remission has become a key treatment goal in today's asthma clinics. We know quite a bit about medications and remission, especially in severe asthma clinics. But what about other factors such as age at onset, sex, obesity, smoking, and allergies in the general asthma population? This study set out to clarify how these features relate to achieving remission in real-world adults with asthma. Researchers used data from the West Sweden Asthma Study. Two large, random adult samples were surveyed in 2008 and 2016. In total, 42,621 people responded in 2008 and 2016 pooled together. 3,955 reported physician-diagnosed asthma. Clinical remission was defined as having no asthma exacerbations defined as hospitalization or emergency room visit due to asthma, no asthma medication use, and no symptoms during the past 12 months. Symptoms included shortness of breath, wheezing, a long-lasting productive cough, or waking up due to cough, shortness of breath or chest tightness. Using this three-component definition, 679 of 3,538 adults met remission about 19%, or roughly 1 in 5. Those in remission tended to be younger, had earlier asthma onset, and higher education level. Those with no remission had higher smoking history, and a higher share of women. Remission was highest when asthma began very early, just above a quarter of people if onset was before age 10, and it declined steadily with later onset, dropping to under 10% when onset was after 60. This pattern held for both men and women. Men with very early onset showed higher remission than women in the same onset category. At later onset ages, remission rates in men and women were more similar. Comparing ever smokers with never smokers, remission was higher in never smokers, especially for those with early onset asthma, less than or equal to 20 years. In men, smoking history didn't show clear differences across onset groups. In women, however, ever smokers with early onset asthma had lower remission than never smokers. Both obese and non-obese participants showed lower remission as age at onset increased. But among those with onset before 10, obesity was linked to lower remission than in non-obese peers with the same onset age. The obesity pattern appeared in men with very early onset. Obese men had lower remission than non-obese men with the same onset age. In women, two groups stood out, those with onset before 20 and those with onset around 40 to 50, where obesity was again linked to lower remission. Participants with allergic rhinitis had lower remission than those without when asthma began early. But in late-onset asthma, remission rates were similar whether allergic rhinitis was present or not. In men, differences by allergic rhinitis were most evident in the youngest onset group. In women, those with early onset asthma and allergic rhinitis showed lower remission than women without allergic rhinitis at the same onset age. Put simply, earlier asthma onset is associated with higher remission. Non-modifiable factors, such as allergic rhinitis, are associated with lower remission rates. In contrast, smoking is a modifiable factor also linked to reduced remission. Another modifiable factor associated with lack of remission is obesity. Preventing these factors is essential to support personalized care and prevention strategies. A heartfelt thank you to all co-authors, the Crafting Research Center team, the study participants, and the funders, and to you for watching. For details, please read the full article or contact the corresponding author via the link in the video description.